Hello. Hello. Come on, guys. You can do better than that. Not for me, just for the client. Please. We are nothing without our client. So our time is precious. So we'll go a little bit faster because I just want to leave the time for Jeff to tell the story because that's the most important thing. So the agenda, we'll talk about cloud modernizations and the journey that Merck has done and has honored us the ability to do it together. So first of all, what it is CloudSMART, and that's the only slide I spent a little bit more time. CloudSMART is the strategy, the portfolio of services for all HCL cloud solutions. We are industry driven, we are very, very engineering driven, we are closer to our partners and our ecosystem. We believe that modernization is the best thing about cloud. If you're doing a journey into cloud, don't bring your technical debt, just bring as much modernization as you can of your applications. We are product-centric, IT-driven, and we are really bet on technology with our clients all the time. So we do it, you know, clients have been doing this journey for two kind of driver. One is innovation-led and one is productivity-led. I think more and more our clients are looking for innovation, for acceleration, for differentiation. I think COVID put a real, you know, magnifying glasses on the fact that cloud can really accelerate innovation, and innovation is needed. Because if you don't have it, then a pandemic comes and you can't connect with your buyers, with your user, with your clients and things like that. But more and more clients are moving to innovation-led, and that's why I think AWS is an amazing platform. I think this morning, I mean, I stopped counting when new things were coming. So we have to be very proud to be able to have AWS as a partner, and they drive innovation all the time. We really have an enablement model. We spend time with our clients. We do smart way days. We believe that is a right way to go to the cloud or to be born into the cloud. We have inside platform to understand the applications. We really follow a methodology that really has worked pretty well with our clients. We did more or less the same thing with Merck. We meet them where they were. We ask the right questions. We build on the pathfinders. And together have grown on their modernization strategy for some really very critical application because, you know, Merck doesn't do things easy. The first thing that they wanted to move, oh, let's take trials. You know trials? You remember the thing we had to do, all the medicine? That the first thing, let's do it that way. So that's really business impacting. This slide is very busy, so I would suggest that if you want to know about our portfolio, come to the booth and we can walk you through, but we have a comprehensive from, you know, start to finish an end-to-end innovation-driven type of solution, very automated machine to human ratio, and we really have an app-centric approach to the cloud. So now that, you know, this little bit of a, we come to the real story, and this is the story of Merck. Jeff, please take it on.
Thank you very much. Everyone hear me okay?
Yes.
Everyone excited for reInvent? All right, thank you. So I'm going to talk about how HCL assisted Merck with our accelerating our journey into the cloud. For those that don't know, Merck is a global pharmaceutical company, been operating for about 130 years now, known as Merck in the United States and Canada, and MSD in the rest of the world. So one thing you'll see here is we've been partners with HCLTech for a very long time. Over 17 years, HCL has been a strategic managed partner providing support for both our infrastructure as well as our applications. So it's this really good collaborative partnership that helped the success of the initiative that you're going to hear from now. So when we moved into the cloud, we didn't want to just move our workloads in there. We wanted to take advantage of cloud capabilities, things like having flexibility and scale. But most importantly, we wanted to make sure that we were in a position where we can continuously advance our capabilities. We wanted to deploy our workloads there, but be in a way that we can continue to iterate and keep enhancing it so we can receive value in the future as well. HCLTech has helped that by developing an application migration modernization factory. That allowed us to develop patterns and, again, continuously upgrade and modernize the applications as they're going inside the cloud. This is all done through agile methodology, so we didn't need to do everything right from the start. We could do in sprint-based models where we can get some wins, receive some value, and then continue to iterate and receive more and more value. And this initiative didn't just look at one aspect. We wanted to look at the complete life cycle of the application. Yes, sir. So first it started with the architecture, understanding what services made up the solution. Then looking at how we're going to administer the application, and then lastly, how that application is going to be operated and supported inside the cloud environment. These are some of the key program factors that went into this Cloud Accelerated Journey initiative. I'll say one of the biggest success factors that we had in the beginning working with HCLTech was this legacy knowledge of our environment. As I mentioned before, we've been partners for a very long time. So HCL having that knowledge of how the applications are built, how the applications are managed, that really allowed us to accelerate a lot faster than if we were to bring somebody else in who wasn't familiar with the essential landscape. What that allowed HCLTech to do for us is analyze thousands of applications very quickly and identify hundreds of applications that were candidates for this migration and accelerated journey inside the cloud environment. HCLTech also brought with it a number of innovative migration capabilities, which, as you've heard, that allowed us to move some really critical applications, enterprise platforms like TIBCO and SAP, into the cloud environment in a modernized way. We also looked across the entire business landscape. There wasn't any one specific area that we wanted to focus on. We wanted to look at the breadth of the entire landscape so we can have as much value as possible. There was several different aspects in there, retire, re-architect, but it spanned everything, and we made the right decisions around what belonged and what would be most successful by going into the cloud environment. The last of the key program factors were related to automation, which is essentially developing patterns in reusable frameworks that not only allowed us to migrate an individual solution, but reuse that in the future. So when the next application came, we didn't need to reinvent the wheel. We were able to reuse that and get the velocity that we were really looking for our migration program. And again, the sprint-based methodology that we used, that really allowed us to continuously see value as we began the migrations and as they were migrated and continue to enhance it as well. But the transformation isn't just of the technology. Jeez. One of the key aspects for this is we needed to ensure that we're able to transform at scale. That meant in addition to the technology, there's the people, processes, and other areas where we needed to make sure that we're transforming it. These are a few of the examples of the areas where we focused. First is around the operating model. So as part of this journey into the cloud, we wanted to transform into a product model where an application or product team is able to support their full end-to-end application or their product. That was a really big change from the Merck side, where it was a lot of throwing tickets over the wall, asking for requests from other areas. But with this transformation, we're able to move into the product and empower teams, empower product owners to support their full solution by themselves. That resulted in defining a lot of roles and responsibilities that these product teams need to have. But then now that we had the roles and responsibilities, yeah, we wanted to make sure that we had the right skills on the team in order to support that. This is where we need to identify what are those right skills that a product team needed. We needed things like product management support, agile support, and then once we identified what was needed, and then we had to work to identify how to get there. So this, just like we did continuous technology enhancements, we need to do continuous talent enhancements as well. So continuing to grow the team with their talent capabilities, so they're not just skilled for what we're doing today, but also skilled for the journey in the future as well. Next area at the scale is related to measuring value. And there's actually two parts to this. Yeah. One is the measuring part. Yeah. So if we don't know where we're at, how are we going to know where we're going in the cloud? So we need to find some common ways that we can develop measurement of our current situation. The second part of it is value. So what we wanted to make sure is all the work that we're doing was being tied back to business value. We want to make sure that we're focused on the key capabilities that really drive our mission statement, saving and improving lives. But we also found it was very empowering to the teams as well, because they understood what they're doing and the importance of what they're doing. Another big important factor was one ways of working. So in the past, things were very siloed, operating different ways with different processes, and it was disconnected. It resulted in delays and a lot of challenges to go at the speed that we really wanted to. So by working on a one way of working in a very connected culture, we're able to streamline a lot of our processes across our different providers as well as internally. I will say HCLTech did a great job providing this and really working closely with Merck in Merck's best interest, which we really appreciated. That collaboration there really allowed the success and really showed that we're working together with one common goal. And lastly, the change of scale is related to the automation and self-service. We wanted to have our product teams develop capabilities that our customers can consume as much as self-service as possible. That's the only way we're ever going to be able to operate at scale, is by offering these capabilities that let the customers consume those, and then lets these product teams focus on developing new capabilities that enhance their product versus taking tickets or requests from the customer. There's a big focus on those automated capabilities. Again, patterns in there that allowed us essentially to develop faster solutions that could be released for the individuals. So to wrap it up, just highlighting a few of the key takeaways. First is, you heard it before, but the shift into this product-centric model. By shifting into the product model, we're able to focus on what the business needs. We're able to build with the business instead of historically building for the business. This introduced a line of innovation thinking inside the teams as well, which we wanted to span across the entire enterprise. Coming up with new innovative ways to solve problems, thinking of product teams as ways to, I want to continue to enhance my solution, make it better, get some more wins, that and spread that across all of IT as well as our whole cloud environment. Again, developing patterns. This is definitely recommended across any migration. As many patterns as you can do, that'll give you a lot of the reuse value as well as that economies of scale to continue to grow. This is also incredibly important for reducing technical debt as well. By developing patterns and maintaining those patterns, it lets us release capabilities using the patterns, but then iterate on those to make them better, and then release those updates directly into the solutions, which keeps capabilities modernized as opposed to creating something, walking away, and then finding that it's outdated later. And then lastly, the integrated processes, this is very important too. If we all have the eye on the same prize, if we're all walking down the same path, this is how we're very successful. We're not spending time trying to solve problems or trying to redo initiatives that we've had, but by having common integrated processes, it allows for very governed migrations, so very structured, very controlled, and very successful in the end. So we're still on this journey into the cloud. We have many more years of these migrations to go, but we're really excited and really happy to have HCL as a partner to join us in these migration journeys.
Thank you, Jeff. The last thing is I want to thank, first of all, you know, Merck for the opportunity. It was a great experience. I actually want to thank our service team because they did a great job to make it happen. And they stayed the course. And the last thing, I think that in this project, we at HCL Tech have learned real life how to really be able to apply product-centric, factory-style application modernization for the client in a very innovative and continuous modernization. This application will not be stale, will never die on, you know, our technical debt, because together we put a lot of thought and experience of how we can maintain this application for the future. I think we our time is up. We want to thank you for listening. I think Jeff is going to be here if we want to ask a few questions. And obviously at HCL Tech booth, you will be able to talk to our expert. Thank you and have a great conference.
Thank you.